Now there are more building blocks that we could lay.
其實係仲有其他嘅嘢嘅。
And I hope that you will discover some more foundations for worship.
我都好希望慢慢你睇到崇拜裡面有啲咩嘅準則。
Foundations from God's point of view.
一啲向從神嗰個角度而出發嘅準則。
Worship architects think about the foundational dimensions of worship so that worship life of a community is biblically faithful.
崇拜嘅結構者佢哋諗嘅究竟係就係崇拜嘅基石，崇拜嘅規格係點樣樣，以致崇拜係變成一個忠於聖經嘅崇拜。
But at this time, I'd like to move to the most important foundational piece, the cornerstone.
所以而家我睇嘅就係崇拜嘅基石。
I think I want to tell you that God has been working in my life for many years to help me understand the importance of the centrality of Christ in worship.
我想講嘅係，即係神係即係好多年喺我生命嘅動工，以至我哋睇到究竟基石崇拜嘅基石係基督呢一樣嘢係幾咁寶貴。
So what I'm going to share with you isn't about theology。
所以我以下會嚟講嘅唔係啲神學上面嘅教導。
It is good important theological consideration, but it's more than that.
當然係有啲神學上面嘅考慮，但係唔止呢一節。
I want to speak from my heart with deep conviction about the truth of what I'm going to share.
我想從心裡面去同大家一齊分享啲嘢。
And all I can tell you is that God has been calling me personally to emphasize this in my teaching.
我就想分享就係神咧，佢係呼召我呢、这個係就係我非常之相信嘅嘢情，就係、是、去。
So when we think about constructing biblically faithful services, here's the most important architectural piece to consider. Jesus Christ is the cornerstone of Christian worship.
所以我哋去諗忠於聖經嘅崇拜嘅時候，最緊要嘅基石就係耶穌基督。
Now I think everyone here would agree with that.But the problem is that we are designing and leading services that neglect this very important piece.
但問題就係我哋不斷係做一啲嘅崇拜出嚟，係忘記咗呢個基石。
I truly believe that rediscovering this reality, the centrality of the presence of Jesus Christ, is the one thing that will most dramatically transform our worship.
我深深嘅相信，嚟到重新嘅去發掘耶穌基督嘅同在係最緊要嘅事情。以呢樣嘢為中心，係能夠係完全嘅去改變我哋嘅崇拜。
We have said that worship proclaims and celebrates the story of God in community.
我哋有講話就係崇拜咧，佢宣告同埋去慶祝神嘅故事。
Well, what is the heart of God's story?
咁究竟神嘅故事嘅中心係乜嘢？
The center of the story is God's Son, Jesus Christ.
整個故事嘅中心就係耶穌基督，神嘅兒子。
In fact, this one reality is what makes Christian worship Christian worship.
而事實上，這個現實是令到基督教的崇拜有基督教崇拜的本質。
If Christ is not the center of worship, we might have worship, but we don't have Christian worship.
如果耶穌基督並不是我們崇拜的中心，我們會有崇拜，但那個不是基督教崇拜。
In many places in Scripture, Jesus Christ is called the cornerstone.
在聖經裡面很多地方，神耶穌基督是被形容為基石、方角石。
There are a few.Mentions of this on the PowerPoint slide.
咁我喺而家大家睇到嘅唔同嘅經文啦。
Now, before modern day engineering, in construction, the cornerstone was a critical piece of the structure.
咁喺以前嘅日子裏面，方角石係一個好緊要嘅起樓，好緊要嘅事情。
The purpose of the cornerstone, architecturally speaking, is to serve as the foundational piece around which the building is established, giving it soundness.
去起樓嘅時候，所立嗰個嘅方角石之後，就會有其他嘅嘢嚟到個成個嘅建築物就係圍住嗰個嘅方角石而起。
And the cornerstone of any building. represents an honored place.
而任何嘅建築物嗰個嘅防角石所代表嘅就係一個非常之受尊榮嘅地方。
For the building is constructed according to its true level and stable placement.
因為每一個建築物所立就係立於嗰個嘅防角石之上。
If the cornerstone is situated perfectly, the entire edifice will be stable.
如果防角石所放嗰個位係完美嘅，咁成個嘅建築物就會係非常之嘅穩固。
Jesus Christ has been given the honored place in worship by the will of the Father.
聖父嘅旨意就係耶穌基督係成為呢一個嘅防角石。
The honor that is due to Christ is not one that was demanded by him, rather it was given to him.
一個崇拜裡面得尊榮的地方，而這個尊榮並不是耶穌基督自己所要求，而是已經是給了主耶穌基督的。
God the Father highly exalted him and gave him the name that is above every name, Philippians 2.
聖父在腓立比書二章教説裡面說到，聖父是將他立在萬民之上。
The stone that was once rejected, God made to be the chief cornerstone. This is the Lord's doing. It is marvelous in our eyes. Psalm 118.
匠人所棄嘅防角石，神係卻要佢去嚟到係得著榮耀，係首要嘅防角石。呢個係神嘅個嘅工作，呢樣嘢我眼裏面看為奇妙，喺詩篇118篇裏面咁講。
Once the cornerstone is set in place,all else flows from there.
防角石立下，所有其他嘅嘢就跟住一齐嚟。
The person of Jesus Christ is the central figure of Christian worship.
所以喺基督教崇拜里面，耶稣基督系最紧要嘅。
Once Jesus is set in place, all else flows from there.
耶稣基督喺崇拜里面系放入咗，所有其他嘢就系跟住。
Now Jesus plays two very significant roles in worship.
咁喺崇拜裏面，耶穌有兩個好緊要嘅角色。
Christ both receives our worship and Christ leads our worship.
基督接受我哋嘅崇拜，並且基督帶領我哋嘅崇拜。
It's a great mystery that one being can fulfill both of these roles at once.
在同一個人身上能夠去做到呢兩個角色，係一個非常大嘅奧秘。
But that is exactly what Jesus is qualified to do as the incarnate God.
但係作為一個道成肉身嘅神，耶穌基督就係咁樣做。
Because Jesus is God, He is worthy of worship, and so He receives our worship.
因為耶穌基督係神，所以佢係值得我哋敬拜，同佢接受我哋敬拜。
But also because Jesus is still human, he is one of us in worship.
但因为耶稣基督是人，他是我们其中一起崇拜。
Let me say a word about each of these.
咁我慢慢去解释呢两样嘢。
First, Christ receives our worship.
首先就是基督接受我们的崇拜。
He is worthy to receive worship.
他是能够是值得去被崇拜的。
When I say that Christ is worthy to receive worship, I'm not suggesting that God the Father and God the Holy Spirit are not also worthy of worship.
当我说基督是去值得被崇拜，我并不是说圣父和圣灵是不值得我们被崇拜。
All persons of the triune God are worshipped.
三位一体的神都是应该是被值得去崇拜的。
The Nicene Creed makes this very clear.
是尼撒圣经里面很清楚的讲到。
More importantly, the scriptures make this very clear.
更加重要的就是经文是这样讲到。
Before the beginning of time, God willed that the Son would receive worship of eternity.
就是在世代开始以前，神已经是希望耶稣基督他是会去接受崇拜。
Hebrews 1:6
希伯来书一章六节这样讲。
When God brings the firstborn into the world, he says,Let all God's angels worship him.
当耶稣基督被带来这个世界，神去讲，是让所有神的天使一起去崇拜他。
At the end of the world, God will place all things under Christ's feet, and Christ will be worshipped. 1 Corinthians 15.
在哥林多前书一章里面去讲到，当世界的末日来到的时候，一切都是在神的脚下面 崇拜祂。
And of course, in Revelation 5,
当然就是启示录五章咯。
Worthy is the Lamb that was slaughtered to receive power and wealth and wisdom and might and honor and glory and blessing.
就是羔羊是那位被值得被崇拜的，那个被杀的羔羊是愿被杀的羔羊得着荣耀和崇拜。
And so when Christians gather on the Lord's Day to worship,
所以当基督徒在主日来到是去崇拜的时候，
we honor the triune God,
我们所崇拜的就是三一神。
Yet this is largely accomplished through the adoration of Jesus Christ.
但这个是我们透过对主耶稣基督的崇敬所做的。
We don't have to worry that the Trinity is in a tug of war about who gets the most attention.
我们不需要担心究竟即是不是拔河这样，三一神他们哪一个位格是更多的得着我们的崇拜。
That's the kind of silly things we worry about from our mindset.
这些我们其实会这样想的。
I promise you,The Godhead has this all figured out.
但神是已经是不需要担心这些东西。
And all we can simply say is that it is God's will that His Son is adored.
神的意愿就是祂的儿子被崇拜。